Hey guys, welcome back. So guys, in this video we are going to start about the React.js tutorial and where you'll be learning about how to build a website. So complete responsive website using Bootstrap we are going to build using React.js. So guys, let's get started with it. So this is our react.js.org website where you'll be learning about building the website. So guys, now first step, let's go to our documentation. So let's click on docs. As you can see, getting started, and now we want to build a website. So this documentation we will follow in future videos where we'll be learning more things about it. So as you can see over here, create a React app. So let's click on this, and below you might see that create a React app. Okay, so here is one GitHub link. So let me just click on this. Okay, so this is one GitHub link to create the React app. Over here you can see, so quick explanation they have given over here, and inside this app also you can see that this, if you want to create a React app, you have to use this link to install and create your app. So guys, to use this npx you need the version node that is 8.10 and the npm is 5.6 above it should be. So then only you can use this npx. So guys, you have to check that. So let's check with it. So before creating any React app, make sure you are having the node and npm installed. So guys, now let's get started with it. So first step, I'll just clear you one node thing. So let me just give control N on it. So this one, just dummy thing, I just want to show you. So over here, first step, we have to install the Node.js. So node.js. So Node.js file you have to install. Node.js. So guys, for Node.js installation, just go to the Node.js website, Node.js, hit on it, and you can get the first link. Over here, you download as per your system requirement and then start using with it. So once downloaded, you can install that and by using next, and then after successful installation, you can check the version. So to check the version, I'll just use my VS Code terminal over here. So right now to check the version, so let me just give check node.js is that node-v. So this is the code to check. So let me just paste over here and hit enter. So I have already installed the node.js, so it's giving me that is version 12.14.0 right now, current version. And then next you have to move on with the second step. So in second step we will be doing about the npm install. So install your npm. Okay, so guys, what we have to do is that now install the npm. So as you see, let's Google that install npm for Windows. Okay, so if you give this and you can get all the npm things, how to install that. So guys, to install the npm, you can see the command over here, or else you can download with that. So first, to install npm you require the node.js. So without node you won't be able to install it. So now you can download this node.js and npm and then install with that. So if you are comfortable with that, you can move on, or else you can give a command to install. So cmd for install, I'll just mention that over here, npm install hyphen g globally where I'm going to install it. So this is a command to install, right? And then once it is installed, you have to run this command over here and make sure installed. After, if you are installed, check with this. So what you're going to check npm. So that command is npm hyphen v. So let's copy this, and now let me just paste over here, hit enter. So you will get the version of the npm. So right now we are working on 6.14.10. this is a npm right now. So after this both installation, then only you can move on with your React.js, so to build the application. So guys, let's move to this GitHub repository thing. overview. Here you can see quick overview where you are using the same link to create the app, and you can use globally also. Okay, so as globally means you can install this npm for create React app if you use this. So let's copy this and I'll just tell you with the note. So in this third step, you can install the React globally, but it's not a good habit. Okay, so React install globally is this is the command. Okay, so as simple, this will be the command. So you have to copy and install. Now if you have installed this, how do you check whether this command is installed or not on your system? So for that, let's give check, where I will type the command over here. So you have to create React app --- version. Okay, so this is the command. So let's copy this command and paste over here. And now let's check. I have already installed on it. So once it is installed, then you can check your version. So it's currently 3.3.0. So this version. So guys, now as per your documentation on the fourth point, let us make a note on it. Like, get back to your Google Chrome and over here, guys. So you can use to create an app directly, create app and your app name. Okay, so we are not going to follow these things. So, but in case you want to use this, install this globally and you want to create app and the app name. So you can just follow with this and create a simple app. So globally installed React creating. Okay, app. So that time you can use this command called React. Let me just mention that cmd: your React app where your app name. So for example, I'm giving funda-app. So this is the command which you are using to create it. Okay, as simple. Then guys, now if you don't want to use this globally, now we have to check with other thing. So there is one more method. So once you create in this format, you can follow with the second one. So which is that npm init where react-app where funda-app. So this is your app. So this is the most of them use this one. Okay, and now which we don't need this. So if you suppose you are not installed this globally. Okay, so if you have not installed it, so that time you can use this fifth method. So fifth method is that direct install or create your React app. Okay, so how will you make this? As simple, let's give cmd, and over here when you run the command for it, you can just go to your Google Chrome and you can see that, just copy this. So it will directly take from the net and make the command for it. So let's paste this. And now, so that this is the npx. So npx means the node module should be above the version. Okay, so above version means we can see that over here. So 8.0 and 5.6. So this, if you want to use this npx. So guys, as you see that we have given my app over here. So instead of my app, I'm going to use Funda app. So we'll copy this and paste into this. So let me paste it. Let's clear this. Okay, and if you paste directly over here, npx create React app Funda app. So this will start creating one folder inside this Funda app. So I have already created the folder, but I want inside that. So let's type as dot over here. Okay, so just let me give one more command for this. You can follow with same thing where you want into the same directory. So this dot you have to add. So I'll just mention one simple, give you a simple note, which creates into existing directory only. Okay, as simple. Done. So these are the five steps which we'll follow with it. So now let's click on and create the app. So I have just clicked on it, where you can see it will start generating the files. Okay. So here you can see all the things. So let me just cut this and just remove it. So if you required, you can just note it down for your reference in future, how to start the React application thing. So these are the 5 steps which we required to do. Okay. So right now I'm just going to leave with this. One more 6th step will be how to serve this app. So once the app is totally created and installed, it will take few minutes. So this might take a couple of minutes. So guys, let's just wait for it and then we will check how the output comes on your Google Chrome. So let's just wait for it to finish. Okay, so guys, you can see many changes have come now. As you can see, it's still installing. So let me just make it to top where you can see all the things. So guys, these are the few which we clicked on it and now it's getting installed and then final it's still doing with it. So we'll be learning much more things about this, how this package is running and doing with this. So in second video, we'll be continuing this React tutorials. So let us just wait for a few minutes where it will finish this. Okay. So guys, finally it has completed now where you can see the success and created Funda app. Okay. So inside the directory, you can run the serve commands, several commands where you can see about the start, run, build, test and eject one. Okay. So about this, we'll be learning in next video about the directory, how this works and what the things are included into it. So guys, now let us use this command npm start to serve this. Okay. So what is our 6th point is nothing but to serve this app. So let us type like run the React app. Okay. So for this, the command is cmd, where my command will be npm start. Okay. So I have, So npm start, let's copy this npm start and paste into your terminal. So let's paste and start the application. So it will just take few seconds to start with this npm start. So it's getting started. React.js start. Let me just make it little top. So guys, starting development server has been started, which means that automatically it will be started in your Google Chrome. Let's go back to a Google Chrome. Okay. It's still loading. So guys, let's just wait for it so that our development server will get started with it. So little bit. So guys, you can see that the React is installed successfully. So as you can see, let us go to our server where you can see that compiled successfully and it is showing at this localhost this point, or else you can move with the this point. Okay. So as simple where the npm is started. Okay. So this is the page. So guys, if you want to edit these things, you have to go to src where app.js file is there and save to reload this page. So guys, if you make any changes, it will automatically reload. So let me just show you one demo. So let us make this little aside and let's come here. And now I want to make it small and the command of this is done. So let me just close this, delete this file. I do not require about it now. Let's finish. And now guys, let's go to our SRC. Let me make it small. So let's, okay. So now we are going to SR and app.js file. So this is the code over here where you can see. So now guys, this is my logo, this React logo. Okay. So let us just increase the little size. And after that, the P tag is over here. And now what we will be doing, we'll just give one more enter and we will create H1 tag and close this H1. And inside this, we are going to type Funda of web IT and I'm going to click on save. Okay. So let's just click save and you can see the change over here. So it will take few seconds to load over here. Let's save it. Okay. So it's building and created successfully. See here. So without doing the refresh thing, it got reloaded. So guys, finally we have completed about how to install the Node.js and npm for to install our React thing. So guys, we have completed the part one of building a website where with the React. We are going to learn about file structure of the React.js app. So guys, as you can see, there are three folders and five files over here. So in this, we are going to learn about see what are the things and how it works. Okay, so first is package.json, where you can see where it handles all the dependencies and your scripts and other things. Okay, so as we see on the dependency, we see many files, and then you see the React, which is the version is 17.0.1. So this is the React version and the React DOM and the React script for to run all the scripts like jQuery, many things about it, and then Vitals. So you'll be learning much more things about this in further videos. So guys, and then the debugging one, scripts where you can just like with the start npm start, where once the project is built, you are completed the project, that time you can build this and npm build, and then you can start with the deployment. So at the deployment time, you have to do this. So for testing and all, we have to work on with this only. And you have one more option for test and one more option for eject. So this is about the package.json file where you can check it. So if you install new things, like for example, you want to install Bootstrap in this. Okay. So that time you can just, the new thing will be appeared with, like, for example, just import this, and then again you are going to copy and paste here. It will be typed Bootstrap. It will be added one more line. So when you install your Bootstrap, so installation of Bootstrap and all will be seeing next video. But in this video, we are going to cover up the file structure and how it's working. So guys, now let us move to this package lock.json, where you can see all the files of it, where it's nothing. We should not know more about it, but it will come. So as a beginner, we do not require now. So let's close this file. And yes, guys. So now let's go to node modules. So inside this node modules, what are the files are nothing but the installed by npm, or you will be able to see this file while creating an React app. Okay. So these are the just packages, whatever included. For example, you required a Bootstrap into your React app, that time it will be installed in this node modules only. So for example, right now it's not installed, but Babels are installed in it. So as that you can see over here. So guys, now let us move with the third, where public, second one. And this inside this public folder, you have a index.html file. So this is the one file application where we are going to run all our project. Okay. So all the project about us, contact us page while creating the website, all will be running through this devroot app. So this is making much complicated this comment tag. So let's just remove that. So we don't require this and all. So it's very simple thing, not much thing. So how this works actually? So this works because of index.html. Whatever you do in the src file and all in the index.js file, that time it will be redirected with this. And from here, your application starts. So guys, let's see what demo for it. Okay. So now let's give npm forward space and start. Npm start, hit enter, and your application will get started. So now starting the development server, now it's automatically redirected to the Google Chrome, and it's opening the localhost :3000. So once it's, I think it's still preparing it. So still starting the development server. So let's just see. So until it get completed this, it will be creating successfully. That time it will show over here. So let's just wait for it. Okay. So now guys, it is installed successfully, and the thing is coming from here. So this fund of abiding is coming from your this root directory. Okay, so all the pages of this design, your logo and this content is coming from this root only on single index.html. okay, so how will you clarify that it's really loading this file only? So if you want that proof, you can just give a forward slash and call index.html. just hit enter, you can see that it's coming into the same page, right? So this is how. So now how this is working, how this data are coming on that. So for that, where you can go to your SRC, inside this SRC folder, you're going to type all your components and your code of React. Okay. So guys, let's move to index.js and see. So where you can see React DOM, where you're rendering and passing document get element by ID, that is root. Okay. So this root will move to this ID. So if you want to change your root name as root app, okay, so let's copy this root app and let's go over here and paste this. Save. Once you save and it started. So guys, now let us just run this application. So you can see that there is no error in it. If you just change over here also, here the difference is this. Okay, so guys, let's make it how it was. So let's make it to root only because we required it, and let's remove. So let's save this file also, and now you can see the same output what you're getting. Okay, so error is coming because it has changed. So let's refresh, you can see the app. Okay, so guys, now what you have to do is how this design is coming, I mean to say this logo and this fund of web IT, how this is coming. So I'll just show you that. So inside this, when your React DOM is rendered over here, so that time you're passing something called app. So this app means you're importing the app name and from your app.js file. So you're not required to include as .js, not required. It will directly understand. So React DOM will and React, this two things will make sure you're understanding that app.js. So just find for this app where you can search over here app.js. cool, and this is your app.js file, and over here you have written fund of web IT, and I'm going to type one more thing, welcome to my channel. Let me save this and you can just see the output of it. So let it get loaded, or you can refresh the page. So let's refresh. You can see that fund of web IT, welcome to my channel. So this is how we work on your React app. So guys, now we have almost done with this, and what are the logos, how this is coming. So I'll just want you to explain this logo also, how this is working with it. So what is that actually? As you can see that you are importing a logo variable where from you are going to call the path of it. So inside your SRC only, so this dot forward slash means you are into the current directory. So existing directory you are in now. So inside this only logo.svg is there. Done. So this logo.svg is calling over here and taking this and putting into curly brace and calling that file, as simple. So this is the code for it, how we view the image or include the image tag. So if you want to remove and all and test with that, you can just go forward with it. So this is how the image is working. So I'll just show you one demo, like removing this and again pasting to it. So let's just give Control X and let me remove this one also. So let's save it. And now let's refresh the browser. Okay, so app SRC. Okay, cool. So the logo has went. Okay, so it was taking some glitch at that time because it didn't load correctly. So for that sake. So guys, now it is successful. You can see that no image is there. So let us just replace that what it was and let's save it, and then you can move on with it. So npm run build. So let's see, and you got the output. So guys, in this video, that's it. So guys, in this video, we are going to cover about how to install or add the bootstrap to your React.js app. Okay, so guys, now let's get started with this. So as you saw all these things in previous video, so let me just close everything over here. And now guys, I want to install an app, I mean Bootstrap. So let's install the Bootstrap. So there are two options on it. So one is like you can use the normal getbootstrap.com to install in your React.js, and one more is like React Bootstrap. So I'll just show you that React Bootstrap also. So let's hit enter and there's React Bootstrap over here. So let me click on it. So this is one React Bootstrap. So what is the difference in this actually? So this is like basic Bootstrap which we use it. So in everyone uses this. And for the React special Bootstrap, you are getting with something else. So let's get started with this React and React Bootstrap. Okay. So guys, just move to this component and inside this, I have selected the navbar where you can see that this is the code for implementing the navbar. Okay. So this is the React Bootstrap navbar. So when you go to your normal Bootstrap, there will be one small difference about it. So here you call with the div tag and calling the things. Okay. So let me just show you. Okay. So navbar is just nav and your div tags and your buttons directly you are including with the HTML. So over here you are making each component of it. So navbar component is there, then toggle component, collapse component, everything works on component. So you have to add this into your headers. So this will be like little complicated things, but we will cover up in sooner videos about this, how to use this React Bootstrap in your JS. So in this video, we are going to install and work with this normal Bootstrap. So getbootstrap.com. So let us click on home page and you can see that installation process. So where you can see this npm install bootstrap next. So let's copy this command and go back to your editor, and over here, let's open your terminal and you can just open with over here only. So you can see the terminal and just click on new terminal and then you can move on with it. So guys, now I'm going to give that command for bootstrap. So right now I'll just show you over here package.json. There is nothing called bootstrap in this dependency. So as you can see it. So let me just paste this and now let's give enter and then install it. So guys, it will take few minutes to install that. So let me just make it top and you can see that the installation process. Okay, so now still here. So let's just wait for few minutes, one more. Okay, it's almost done and one package added from the contributor. Okay, so let's just wait for the final installation, Bootstrap 5.0 beta 1. Okay, so let's just wait for the finishing of it. Okay, so guys, finally it has been downloaded. So now let us just minimize this terminal and you can see that the new line which has added in your package.json file. Now we have to include this file into your directory and let's test with that. So let me close this and now guys, let's get started with it. So guys, now let us see that the bootstrap is present or not into this. Okay, so let's open this node module and just scroll it down where you can find with boot. Okay, so these are there but bootstrap is not there. So for that, let's refresh this and let's check with that. Cool. So bootstrap is come over here, right? So let us just see over here, bootstrap, dist and CSS, then the bootstrap files are available into this. Okay. So guys, you are going to call this bootstrap.min.css file. So as you remember, bootstrap, dist, CSS and bootstrap.min.css. Okay. So we have to include this. So guys, now let's go to our src folder and index.js file. So this is the main page where you are going to include all your things into your app, and this app is called into your index.js as you can see over here. Okay, so guys, now let us include it. So let me just right now we don't require this, so but then too we will just ignore that and we'll keep it over here. So let's import that bootstrap. So let us type guys. So there are many methods of printing this. So let's import and then you can start with the double single quotes and inside that single quote you're call the path. Okay, so as you can see it's in the node module folder. You can call the node module folder also, but we don't require it because this is React will import directly. So guys, for that, let's start with bootstrap /dist/css/ your bootstrap min.css file. Okay, so you have to call this path as you can see over here. So let us just confirm with that. Let me just scroll it down. Okay, where is it? Here, bootstrap. Okay, bootstrap distinct where CSS and bootstrap min.css. So let me just click on it. If you want the path of it, you don't remember, means you can just copy this path where you can just right click or else move on with it. Okay, here let's scroll it and copy path. Okay, so let's give copy path and let me close this and just I'll paste it now over here. So to show the demo, so let's paste this. Okay, so this is the path right now you're getting. So you can copy directly from here, from the node module, and whatever is there, just remove that and add into your this folder. Okay, I mean this path. So let's save it. And the thing you have to change with that forward slash. Okay, so not backslash. And this node module we do not require. So you can just remove it and save the file. And now guys, we have to include the bootstrap.bundle.css, okay, JS file. So as I will just show you in the documentation of this get bootstrap, when we get started, you can see that one is the CSS file that we have included now, and then one more is the JS file. So in this bundle.min.js file, which is already the bootstrap and the popper is included and made into bundle. Okay, so if you want the separate thing, you can push on with this popper and bootstrap min.css. So guys, now what we'll do, we'll just use this bootstrap bundle.css. Okay, I mean JS. So let's get back and input once again and call this as min.css, and instead of bootstrap, you will just tell bundle, B-U-N-D-L-E. Okay, so if you want to find this path, let's go to the bootstrap. So let me just move on with the node modules. So where is it? Okay, this is the bootstrap, right? And yep, so let's minimize this. Let's open this JS and you can see the bundle.min.js. So let us scroll this. Over here you can find that bundle.min.js file. So let me copy the path and import the class. So guys, why I'm copying this bundle.min.js, I will just show you the demo also for it. So let's paste the path over here and take what the things are required. So let's control X and remove this. And now let's include that over here. Paste. And let's change this as forward slash. Now guys, it is set. And now to test, we will move on with the app.js file. So let me just go to app.js. And here is our something code of old thing. So let me just make sure we are getting start with this npm start. And let's click on it. Your development server will be started. Okay, so it's compiled successfully. And now let's see the output. So guys, this is the output right now I'm getting. So we'll just remove all this and start with the bootstrap one. So for example, we will choose with the navbar. Okay, so navbar and one button. Okay, so we will get started with choosing the button. Okay, so guys, as you know, bootstrap button things on all is present. So I'll just show you directly demo. So guys, now we will remove the things from here. So I just don't want this app dot CSS. So let me remove. And now guys, we will remove this data from here. So I don't require this. Just remove that. And let's tell container. And inside this container, I am going to design one button. So let me just move on with one button, simple design. So let's open this, open button and close. And now here, I'll just tip click me. Okay, so let's save this and we don't require this. So let's remove this also. Just give import React from colon, where I'll just call the React. That's it. And now, guys, let's save this. And now you can see on your output. Let's refresh. It's taking a bit time. Okay. So guys, there is nothing over here. So why it is? Let's see on it. Okay, so I didn't save the file. So for that sec, it was not showing the output. So guys, you can see that click me, it's over here. So this is the basic comment button. Okay, so guys, I want to add a bootstrap. So let me just show you the class where into this single. So it is not going to take a HTML class attribute. So we have to assign this because this class is already taken by React JavaScript thing. So we can have to define with the class under class capital NAME then name. So now over here button where I'm going to use primary. Let's save this, control S, and you're compiled successfully. And let's see over here, you can see this green color, blue color. So this is a primary for the bootstrap. So now guys, same way you are going to install, just check with the one more output. Oops. In this, the HTML div tags are not getting moved on. Okay, so let me just paste with that. And over here, I'm going to use one simple card of bootstrap. So let me just type with card. And now let us copy this and paste one more thing, which will be card-body. And inside this, I'm going to call this button. So let's see the final output of that. Save and let's get back over here and let's refresh. So you can see some card design, right? So guys, that's it. And now let me just show you with one more sample called shadow, so you can finally clarify with that. Okay, so you can see all the bootstrap is installed successfully. So guys, this is how we install the bootstrap into the React app. So guys, in this video, that's it, and we'll be moving with the next part. So guys, now we are going to learn about how to create a page into a React file. For example, about the home page and your about us page, contact us page. Okay, so we'll be creating with that. So guys, let's get started. So now where you see this is a fresh application, right? And now over here inside in SRC, we have to start creating all your things about the pages. So guys, we will follow a folder structure to make it very clear, understandable, and optimization. So guys, now let's create one folder called components. So let me just type components, components. And inside this folder, I'm going to create one more folder called pages. Okay, so let me type pages, P-A-G-E-S, pages. And then one more folder called includes. So INC we can type. So shortcut for includes is INC. So includes might be like keeping the slider and the images, navbar, sidebar. So for that thing, we will use that. And one more thing, we want that for the images purpose. So let us create the images folder also into it. So we have created successfully, but right now we are going to create the pages for it. So let's create one home page. So let me just type capital H and home .js file. So let's hit enter and our home.js file is created. So now let's create one more page for the about us. Okay. So now let's create one about us page. About about.js about page and one more page called contact. So three pages we are going to create on it. So let me just type contact.js. So this is our three pages now. So guys, these pages should be printed on your home page, about us page, and contact us page. So guys, now let us create one simple interface to show that these are the pages. So first we will import the React to use their classes and many more things. So import React from your React. That's it. And now create a function. So let's type function home function and space open curly brace close curly brace. And now we have to export this. So export default where your home this. Okay, so you have done with this. So once you what the function should be returned is that let's return where you are going to open and close the braces and then divide that. Inside this you want to create a thing. Okay, so guys, let's divide. So let's give a simple HTML thing. So in previous video we have used the bootstrap, so link is available in the label and now description, and then we will create here. So let's create one bootstrap classes. So class name is equal to where you are going to create one container, and inside this we are going to create one card. And now let's create a class name is equal to where card, and same thing we will copy and paste again, and let's rename this as the card body. So card body, and here margin top where we'll give 4. Let's save this, and now guys we have to give a h2 tag. So let me give open h2 close, and then over here we'll tell home page, as simple. So guys, this is the home page and it's returning. So guys, same thing we are going to copy and paste into 3 pages also, about us. So let me paste in about us and change the function name. So about us, you can just type about, or you can create about us also like this. So let's create that about us and let's save, and then change the page name about us, and then let's same thing copy and create in paste in contact us. So let's just change this name also, just give control D and type contact us. So that's it, 3 places also changed. Done guys. So now we have to call this home page onto this browser. Okay, so this was the default. Make sure your npm is started. I have already started with that. So how this is loading on your home page, /. Okay, so over here you can see this, click me, it's loading because of this into your app.js. So it's over here. So once you see this app.js, it's coming over here, right? So we want to remove this and call the home page. So guys, now let's call that home page. So let me import called home from the path you have to call it. Okay, so how will you call the path of it? So as you can see that you are in the directly src folder. Okay, so app.js in src. So you have to give from current directory, you are going to components, components folder / pages / capital H home.js. Okay, so this is the file. You do not require .js thing because React will understand that is JS file only. So guys, you can see the path and clear that thing. So now let's import this into is return where you can return this app. So let's call that capital HOME / and end. Okay, set, and now let's load the page. Let's get back. So let us just refresh. So those were the errors which just now flashed. Those were while setting it because React loaded per second, or else when you save the file. Okay, I have kept on auto load, auto save. So that time only it's getting automatically saved per second. So that time, for that sake, it was showing an error. Okay, so we are on the home page, and now you want to call the about us page also same way. So let's copy and paste and let's rename to about, and let's call the about us page. So about us, just call this about us. So as you can see, about.js. So let's call this, and same thing or copy and going to paste where you can see that about page, and then same way for the contact also. So let's type contact and import this also. So let's import contact and copy this and call the contact page. Done. Okay, so guys, now we have to execute this. So it's showing this error because we have not, as you can see that this expression must have a parent element, which means this div tag should be included into it. So like it should be inside one thing. So you can see the output also where it is telling one error. So guys, let's make that into one div tag. So let's just cut Control X and create one simple div tag. So hit enter and paste over here. That's it. And let's move this little forward, and now there is no error. So guys, now let us see, and you can see that. Okay, I think it's a catchy. So let's refresh the page once again. You can see that home page, about us and contact page, right? So guys, three pages have been included. So guys, that's it in this video, and we'll see about the navigations that is known as React routes in React app. Okay, so guys, for example, I want to tell, like, if you click on this home page, so the home page should be loaded. If I click on like forward slash about, if you give the about us page should load, and the contact, then the contact page should be loaded. Like that, we have to work on it. We are going to learn about the React routes, or we call it that also as a React router. Okay, so we are, as you saw now, this was the output till now. So now I wanted to make a redirect URL thing. Okay, so when I click on home page, so we will set the URL. Okay, so guys, as you, for example, if we give slash, that time it should be home page, that which this page should load, and when we click on about us, about page, then about us should load, and the contact, if I click, the contact page should load. So guys, for that, let's get started. So guys, now we have to install a router. Okay, so let's go and type React router router. So once you click on this, you get a website where reactrouter.com, specific website. So let me just open this, and you can use this also. So where you can see that npmjs.com, where you get all the packages of the npm. Okay, so I'll just show you the command for installation is like npm install where React router. If you give this command, the router will install two things. One is the for the React router DOM, and one is for React router native. But we don't need this. We are not working on React native thing, right? So we will be using only React router DOM. So you can just copy this and start executing. I mean, just start this installation. So let's copy this, and now in this second step, you are getting with this website where let's click on web, and you will be quick start, where you can see that the installation command for React route over here. Okay, so let me just copy with that. Okay, let's copy, and now let's get back to VS Code, and then over here we will the npm is started. So let's close this. So guys, I have stopped the terminal, and I have closed that terminal. And now guys, we will start the terminal inside this application, VS Code only, and then we will give the command for it. So what you copied just now is this npm install react-router-dom. Okay, so you can just use with npm install react-router-dom and hit enter. You can install directly in your package. So before, we'll just go to JSON package. So you can see there is no React router DOM, right? Installation is completed. That time your React router DOM will be shown over here. So let's just wait for it, for the installation. So guys, finally it is installed now. Let me just make it little top, and I'll just show you what is the installation. So we just run this command, and now finally it has been installed with it and created. So guys, let me just minimize with this, and then guys, we are going to check in our package.json whether this is installed or not. So as you can see that here one extra line has been added, so a React router DOM which is added. So let's save this, and let me close this file. So package.json we have closed, and now guys, let's route it. So for that, we have to start the npm start. So let's give npm and start. Okay, start, hit enter, and your serving will be started. And then we will be back to this page. Okay, so let's just wait for it to get started. So guys, it's starting the development server, means it is still loading. Okay, so let's just wait for it. So guys, now our npm is started. So as you can see, there's the localhost. So let us just go to our Google. Okay, so our pages is open now. Now what we have to do, guys, we have to set the route for it. Okay, so what is that route we are going to set is nothing but about shifting the things. So guys, we will copy one navbar and create for it. So let's go and finish it soon. So let's click on this search box and type navbar. So I have clicked on it, and if you scroll it below where you can find the navbar. So let's copy this navbar. This is more fine. So let's copy and paste into the your pages. So as you, if you know that we have created in previous video about this, how to create pages in React.js. So let me click and create one new page called navbar.js. So let me just make that and let's save it over here. So before pasting your code, we have to import some things. So we can just copy from your home page. So let me just copy Control A and Control V. Okay, so copy and paste Control A, C and V. So now we have to create that function called navbar, and we have to export this with the default navbar. Done. Over here, you're going to change to your thing. Okay, so what is that thing is nothing but your navbar, which you copied just now. So let me copy once again, and now we will paste it. So let me close this. And now guys, we have to set this. So before setting, you are getting some errors, right? So this div tag is missing something else. So which means only one error might be we are getting is nothing but about the closing tags. So the close tag is coming from where? So we don't require this form. Let me just remove this. So there is some missing about the forward slash arrow. So as you can see that this HR tag is shown over here. So you can read that HR. So HR is over here. And now let us end this with the forward slash. Okay, so you have to give forward slash. Done. So the second error is about, okay, let me just think, and it's not a valid URL. So let's just remove this and give one forward slash with that and just ignore. So whatever is that, you can just change with it, as simple. So guys, we will be doing about this. So let's remove unwanted things and we will include only the things we require. So let's remove. Done. And we require two. And over here also I'm going to give right now forward slash. So guys, now let us include this navbar into your main page called app.js. So let's copy and paste this and make it to navbar where you're going to import navbar. So if you're not understanding, please watch out the previous video how you're importing these files and calling into it. So as simple, where I have created this navbar, right? So it's going to that component folder and then inc and navbar.js. So .js is not extended. So let me copy this and include over here. So let's copy this and copy the file name, not file name, the navbar code and paste. And now let's execute this over here. So let us just refresh the page over here. It's telling can't resolve. Okay, we have not given the correct path. So inside component inc folder, okay, inside inc we have set the navbar. Okay, so let's refresh again where you can see a navbar now. So let's refresh. Cool. So navbar and home and link, it is shown over here. So guys, now let us set a link for it. So as you have installed your router, so guys, now let's start with that linking part. So import where route, not route directly, we have to include those things. So for open curly brace and close curly brace from your installed package. So what the package name is nothing but React Router hyphen DOM. Okay, so this is the package. And what are the things you are going to use is that, so in this file navbar, I'm going to use only the links of it. So let us just call link link. And we are going to use this. So let's copy this. And if you want to like check how it is working, this link, then you have to go to your this React router. They have given what an example. So let's move with that. Okay, so let's copy this and let me just get back to the code. And now we, instead of this tag, we have to paste it. So we are not going to use a tag, and we'll just take its class item control X and paste the class into this link tag. That's it. So let's remove this a tag, and same thing you have to do with each one. So let's copy this link tag and paste to the a tag. Okay, let me copy this and let's paste, and then change the navbar brand, control X, and paste over this and make it to Funda of Web IT. So this will be the brand, and here guys I am going to use MS. So now now let us copy this and create the about page. So let's paste that, and then again copy and make the third one, which is will be the contact us. So this one will be about us. Let's copy and paste, and we are going to make this as contact us. So let's create a route for it. So home page means it will be a default, and now is the about, 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 and the third one which will be linked to contact. Okay, so guys, we need to remove this. So let me just remove this line. Done. So once it's done, now let us just refresh and see whether the error is there or nothing like that. So let's refresh. So we refresh the page, and okay, you should not use link outside a router. Okay, so you have to mention a router for it. So guys, how will you mention this? So let's get back and paste the router. So let's go to our app.js, and over here where you are fetching that, you have to set a router for it. So let us call the router, router open and router close. Okay, oops. So over here inside this you have called the router. So let's call the router over here. So what we have to do, just import where open curly and close curly from your React DOM. Let's call React router DOM. Okay, and inside this you have to call the browser one. So let's type browser router as, I am going to rename this as shortcut, so we'll known as router. Okay, and where you are going to set that one more thing. Okay, so first let us see with the router thing. So let me just cut and paste below this div tag. Okay, done. So it's included now inside it. So let's save this, and now let us refresh where you can be able to see. Let's refresh. It's so guys, the navbar is loaded now. So let me just click on home. So, and let's click on about. So the URL has been changed to about, and let's click on contact. So it is changed to contact. Cool. So you can see that linking is working fine with it. So now what we have to do, we have to change this according to the pages. So if I click on home, that home page should show. If I click on about, the about page should show, and as well as for contact. So guys, let's set that. So first step, you have to use the route. Okay, so as simple, I'll just show you. Okay, so let's create a route. Route. And now in this route, we are going to call the path for it. So not router, we have to set a route. So this route, let's call the route over here. What is route? Okay, so in this route, we are going to call the path of it. So let's type path is equal to double quotes, not single quotes, where forward slash home. So inside this route, you will set the home thing. Okay, so let me cut and paste inside it. Done. And now this navbar, make it at beginning over here. So let's just keep it at the beginning top. And same way guys, you have to replace with the other things too. So let's paste. Okay, and now let us copy the about and paste inside this, and let's copy the contact and paste inside this. And let me just remove these two things. Set. So we have set the path of the pages. So how will you set with that same URL path you are going to use it? Okay, so over here about, and coming to the path of contact page where you will show contact. done, and now let's see what's the result for it. So let's just refresh. Okay, so you can see that about page means it is showing about. So let me click on home. So home page, it's loading, and now if I click on about us is showing, and let me click on contact us, contact page is showing, right? But there is one problem, that home page is loading statically, right? So to make sure that exact path what you are loading, to load that page, you have to use switch in React. So for that, let's change with that. So let's create a switch for it, switch. Let's open close. And now let me just cut this and paste at last of your route. So whatever the route you're using, make sure you're inside the route. So all your route should be inside your route. Okay, inside the switch. So let's copy this and define the switch over here. So from here, you're getting the switch. Okay, not from here to here. From here, you're getting to here. Done. So now guys, what we have to do, if you're using switch, you have to call one exact path. So exact path will be for the forward slash home, because this forward slash is used everywhere. So for that sake, we are using exact. Okay. So exact thing will be called. So let's save, and yes guys, so let's load. So let's refresh on this page. Okay, I have refreshed now. Cool. So you can see that about us is about us URL. It's showing only about us page. And coming back to home page, so forward slash, which is home page. And now let's click on contact us. You can see the contact page. So these three pages has been loaded. So this is the concept of React router. So guys, as I have made few changes on the navbar, just a simple code I have added with the background black, and I have kept this navbar into a container. Okay, so this is the change from the previous video from now. So guys, now what we want to do, in this video we are going to cover the topic of how to link the image in React app. Okay, so React.js. So guys, now let's get started. So let me just show you about that navbar design. So I have just took the navbar background and bg dark, navbar dark, where shadow I have added into a container of column of 12. Okay, and simple, then kept the navbar inside in it. So that was the change. That's it. And now guys, let's begin with that. So yes guys, so for example, we will move on with the slider. So I wanted to tell that we are going to link the image. So to link the image, we need one thing, right? Image tag. So let's go a demo with the slider one. So let's go to our getbootstrap.com documentation. And over this, we are on the 5.0 version. Okay, so let's type carousel, C-O-R-O-U-S-E-L, carousel. Okay, so let's click on that and let's see, the carousel comes over here. And now guys, you can see a demo over here. So this is one static demo, and over here you can see some images, right? Like sliding thing. So let's move on with the third option, where you can get this, all these labels and all, and with the image slider, where you get this bottom also, right? So let's copy this demo. So let me click on copy, and now let's paste this into our slider. Okay, so guys, now let's create one folder inside inc, where I want to create on, not folder, a file. So slider.js, and inside this slider I'm going to paste the code. So how we cannot paste directly. So what we have to do is that we have to call a function into it. So let's just control X and let's call the React. So import React from your React. Okay, React, and then need to call the function of slider function, open close curly braces, that is flower bracket, and here you are going to return it, return function. Okay, so it's just brackets, not curly brackets. And now your code will be pasted here. So once this is done, let me just arrange this in a simple format. Okay, so now when you have created this slider, so let's export this. So we need to export. So let us export default of your slider. That's it. So So there is some error. So guys, let's see what the error is about. Okay, so as you can see, let me hover on this. JSX element div has no closing tag. So inside this, where there is no closing tag. Closing tag means you have to give a forward slash. So let me just check with that. Okay, so we are able to find that on the image tag, we don't have a closing tag. So let's give Control D and just give add forward slash before the close tag. Let's save it. And you can see there is no error. So the error comes only because of this most of the time. So now it's set, and you can see the export default slider done. And now guys, we have to link the image. So first step, you have to, how do you link over here? So first you have to call from this path. So guys, before importing the link of your image, you have to store into this images folder as we have created in the beginning. So I have kept one image with the React only. So let me just copy this image and include into my Funda app folder. Okay. So as you can see that this is a Funda app. Inside this SRC, I'm going to on the components, inside components, I'm going to images, where I will post this as slider1.jpg. Okay. So this is the image now. So guys, now let's get back. So now move to our VS code and then let's call that path. So as you can see in this folder, you are getting that slider one. Now guys, let's continue. So over here is, let's import your slider one, you can tell. Oops. So let's remove this slider one from the path. So the path is about, so right now your slider.js is currently over here. So one step you are going back and then going to images folder and then you are getting that, right? So let's give double dot forward slash. You are now out of the folder. Now let's call images folder forward slash and then your slider1.jpg done. And let's save this. So guys, now you are going to use this. So let's copy this and call into your image tag. So let's remove this double quotes and the whatever it is inside that. So just SRC is equal to curly brace open close. Inside that curly brace, you are going to paste. Done. Simple. So now guys, what we have to do, just copy this and paste wherever you require images. So let me just paste the place of image. SRC saved. And now guys, let us execute and see. So my npm is already started, so you can see over here. So let us just refresh this page. Okay, so it's not coming. Why it's not coming? Because you have not linked this slider page into your home page. Okay, so let's call this slider and into your home page, because we don't want into all the pages, home page, about page, contact page, you don't want, right? So we need only in home page. So let's include this file slider into your home page. So guys, you can see that home.js file is over here. If you're not able to understand, please watch out the series from beginning. So it will be very clear and understandable. So guys, now let's include it. Okay. And now inside this container, I'm going to paste that slider. Not inside the container. So let's not inside the container. We have to create one div called, let's create one dummy div just without classes. Okay. And this div will be at the bottom. So let me just cut and paste over here. And over here, your homepage section is there, right? So React always needs a wrapping tag. So it should be, all things will be inside one div tag. Done. So guys, now let's include the slider. So how will you include that? So let's first import with the name called slider from the file name. So the file name is inc. So you are in the home page. So let's get back one step and then go to inc and then get the slider. So let's get back one step back and then move to inc folder. Inc means includes folder. Okay. And then get the slider. And dot js not required to type, because this will understand, React can understand that it's a js file. So guys, now let's copy this slider and paste over here. So just paste and forward slash close the tag. As simple. So let's save this, and now you can see some changes on the website. So let's refresh it again. You can see, cool. So you can see the output, right? So now your image is imported perfectly on your home page. So guys, now let's design the home page. So in this home page, I want to make three sections. So first section will be about the company, and then our vision mission, and the third section will be about service, and the fourth one will be final footer. So guys, let's complete that in this video. So let's get back, and yep. So as you left in previous video, so let me just close this. Done. So let's close all the files from here, and now I'm going just on home page. So I have clicked on home page, and now guys, as you can see that it's dummy data over here, right? So you can see this. So guys, now let's begin with that. So now first step, we are going to create a section. So let me just remove this, all these things we don't require. So let's begin with div tag. So let's type div, where, and then inside this you are going to assign the class name it is, okay? And now you are going to create a section for it. So let's create that section for this. So let's make it to section, and now this will be as section. Done. Let's save this, and this class name we are going to create. So how will you include this? So first let us add the CSS for it. So as you see on the app.js, you're calling all the things, right? So I want to add the CSS on this file only. So let us create one app.css. So you can see that app.css already existing. So let me just control A and remove everything, and let's begin with our code. Okay. So let's go to app.js file and include this app.css into it. Done. So let me just import at the top only. So import, where we will tell that CSS thing. So directly you are going to call the path, and that path will be called like it's in current directory only. So let's give dot and forward slash, where capital A P P then dot CSS. That's it. Now your CSS link is included into your app. So all the apps are connected with this. So let's get back and start the code. So first we were on the section part. So you can type that section. And now over here, guys, we are going to set the padding. So padding top, where we will set this as 40 pixel, and same for the padding bottom. So let us save. Let's give me a semicolon. Okay, done. So after this, then you can move on with this step. So section is included. Done. So now guys, as simple, you can create a div tag with the class name of container. So let's copy this class is equal to, where double quotes. Let me just copy this and keep, let's copy and make it to container. And let's create one more div and make this as row, where now let's create one more div for the column. So we are using Bootstrap. So oops, so let me just paste. And this will be column MD12, and we will give this as text hyphen center. And now you are going to create the main heading. So let's type h3 tag over here, and you can tell our OUR or company heading. So let's assign the class for this. Class name is equal to, where you can tell main heading of it. So let's copy this class and paste into your app.css. Done. So let me just add that. And now guys, inside this main heading, we have to include the code for it. So let's type that. I'm going to give a color, where I'm going to assign RGB color, where for red, little 204, 18, 18. So this will be my red color, where I'm going to give this font size as 26 pixel right now. And let's save this and go back to your home page, and this will be called. So guys, now let's create one underline. So let's open div and close the div. And now inside this, you can create a class. And below this, I'm going to create underline class. Okay. And let's give MX underscore auto to be in center. So let's copy this and paste over here. So let's create the underline code. So over here, I'm going to create a height of 0.4 pixel and W width of 4 REM. Okay. And then background color we are going to give for it. Background color with the 7 6 C 2 F. Okay, this will be the orange color where I'm going to create margin top for it, which will be 10 pixel, and again margin bottom, which will be 10 pixel. So guys, let's save this and I will just show you output of this. So let's get back to our browser. Let's refresh the page. Okay, so the output is currently this. So guys, now let's add the paragraph for it. So now let me just click on the below and open the p tag, and inside this you are going to add the paragraph. So guys, now what we have to do is we need a dummy content. So let's type dummy content. So you will get a lorem ipsum website. So this is for the dummy content. Right now I'm adding it. So let's copy some text of it. Copy and get back and paste. That's it. So let me save this. And now we are going to create one more link to show the output. So the tag is over here. And now guys, let us click create a link. So in React, this link means a tag. Okay. So this is referred as a tag is equal to double quotes where forward slash I'm going to give about. Okay. And this about will be known as read more. So this is the, and let's create the class for it. So I'm going to use Bootstrap class, class name where button hyphen warning, and I'm going to use one shadow. So let's save this and check the output. So if you're using a link, make sure you're importing the link. So let's import inside the curly brace where you're going to type this link link, capital L link from your React DOM. So you have to install your React DOM, React router DOM. Okay, that's it. And let's see the output of it. So let's refresh once again. Cool. So the design is fine now. So guys, let's create the second section of it. So let's move on with the second section. So second section, what we are going to create is about our vision, mission and values. Okay, so this is the second section which we are going to create. So for this to create, let's create one simple includes folder into it. Okay, so where I can include into my about us page. So let me just create include folder inc, and inside this I am going to tell create a file called vmc, okay, .js. So let's make it small, vmc.js, where vision, mission and core values we can tell this. Okay, and now we are going to include that file into this. So we are going to learn about this also, how to include that. So guys, let's copy this and design it now. So let's copy and paste, and now guys, you can mention that vision, mission and values. So let's copy, and now I'm going to remove this two things. Done. And now as simple, we are going to create a column for it where I will make this margin bottom 5, and now let's create column MD4. So let's create a div tag, and inside this I'm going to create a class name is equal to where column MD4 will be there, and then inside this, excuse me. Okay, so now over here we have to include the card. Done. So not, we are not going to include card, we'll just directly we'll type it. So let's include a H6 and close over here. Here you can tell our vision, and below this let's mention the paragraph of the mission. Okay, So let's copy some dummy content of it, which we have already copied it. Okay. So let me just copy these three lines of it. Copy and paste. So let's see the output of one box and then we'll move on with the other two. So let's see. Cool. So it's coming this much, right? So now guys, I want to make it in center and little bit color difference. As simple, what we have to do is that let's move it to text center, text hyphen center, as simple. And then you're going to add us inside this section. I'm going to add BG hyphen LIGHT light. Okay. So this is the gray color background. Okay. So over here, this is the bootstrap gray color, but I want to make my custom gray color. So C light I am going to add. So let's copy this variable and let me just change this. Okay. So let's copy this CSS class and paste into your app.js and assign a color for it. So let's create the color where I am going to create with the background hyphen color colon hash F2. So this will give a gray color for us. So let's save and let's get back and you can see the difference, guys. So the gray color has come over here now. And now what I wanted that. So let's make it this little border on this. So let's tell that you can tell border hyphen top. If you give border top, one border color will be created on it. So you can see a light border done. So same way you're going to copy that vision, mission and core values. So let me just copy and paste it again and again. 1 and 2. So 3 columns, 4, 4, 4, 12 it's divided. And let's change the heading for it where you can tell this as mission and our core values values. Core values, let's save it. And this code will be included in your where VMC. So let's paste that. So before pasting, you have to call that import React from home React. Okay. And let's create the function. So let's create function called VMC function where vision, mission and core values, open curly brace, close curly brace, then return the function. And inside this, you're going to paste your code for the design. So let's align this. And now we have to export as default. So let's do export default, FAULT default of this. Done. And now guys, let's call this function, this page into your home page. Now let's call that. So we are in the home page and over here you want to assign it. So let's create one called VMC function and end that. And let's import it. Import VMC from the path. So what is the path right now? You can see it's in the current directory only. I am going to INC folder. So let's go to current directory ./ where INC /, your page name. So that is VMC. Done. And now it's included. And now guys, you can see the same output of it. So let us just refresh. Okay. And now you can see the same value. So guys, now let's create the third section about including the image and the linking the tags. Okay. So guys, now let us just go back and create about the third section where you will be seeing about the services. So as simple, we'll tell this our services. Let's save. And now you are going to create with the service section. So same as this. So we are going to copy from the VMC only and paste over here. So let me go back to VMC and let's copy and make some changes into this. And we are going to use the same thing. So let's copy and paste. So it's now as simple. We will change the heading as our services. And then inside this our services column MD4. I wanted the card design. So let me just remove all this text center I don't need over here. And as simple, let's create the div tag. So let's open and close the div tag. And now guys, we are going to create a class into it. So class name is equal to where I'm going to use the card. So let's copy this. And inside this card, I'm going to use one shadow also. Okay. SHADOW shadow. So bootstrap classes we are using and making the designing. So let's just move with this. And now over here inside card, we are going to remove this and type the card body body. And now guys, we are going to include one image. So let me just open the image tag and give /and close the tag. And now you are going to use src is equal to, inside this you can call the service one, and this image will be linked from above. Okay, so before linking, let's create the class name also, where I'm going to give that as width 100% and border bottom. Okay, so border bottom will be created. If you want the alt tag, where you can tell services. And now what we are going to do guys, this image should be before the card body, so let's replace that over there. And inside this you have to include the h6. Okay, and tell service one, and we are using one underline which we created in the beginning. So like, let me close the div. Okay, and now we are going to create a class name is equal to where underline done. And now over here p tag, so inside this p tag the dummy content will be, so let's copy and paste, done. And let's remove unwanted things which we don't require. So let me just remove this also. We'll just test with one condition. So now we have to link the image, so let's copy this and call the image path at the beginning. Let me just minimize. Okay, so let's call the image import where service one from the path. Okay, so the path name is, as you can see inside the image, image one dot jpg is there, right? So I'm going to call that image one dot jpg. So let's type, where are we actually? This is the home page. So inside we are the pages. So let's get back one step backside and then call the images folder. So to get one step back, let's give /// images/ and image.jpg. Okay, image1.jpg file, it's there. So now it's assigned, and now let's check the output for it. So let me save it and let's get back. Let's refresh the page. Okay, so this is the output guys, and now you can create one read more button, but these texts are looking too huge, so let me just give one CSS for it. So as simple, I'm going to create one p tag, and inside this font size will be 14 pixel. Okay, and the color will be #26 26 26. So this will be giving a light kind of black color. So let's refresh. So you can see the text has become small and it's looking pretty cool. So now let's change this background color for this services section. So let me go on home page, and we have to remove this background color. So this BG custom light I don't want, and let's save this over here. So now we are satisfied with this design, and now guys we want to add one simple link. So let me just add that link over here, open tag and link, so capital LINK link, and close the link. And inside this we are going to call the true, where so let me just give is equal to inside this and give the services. If you are creating a services page, you can call that. So class name is equal to where we can tell as read more, and inside this read more will give button link of Bootstrap. So let us save this and check the output of it. So let's see. Okay, so cool. So you can see that read more button has come over here. So this is how we move on with it. So let's copy and paste this 3 times to print the card. So let's copy and paste. If you want, you can include this in another page for the section purpose. So now let's minimize this guys, and let's work on the footer part. So footer part, what is that? We want on all the pages, like home page, about us, and contact us page. So as simple, let's create with that. So let me just finish with the footer also. So let us go to our main page, where is SRC inside components, inside includes, as we have created navbar slider. So inside this only I'm going to create the footer page. So let us finish it very soon, this also. And now guys, we will continue. As simple, first step, import the React from your React, okay? And then create a function with the name footer function, and let's open close curly brace and let's return the value. So return function, and inside this the code of your footer. So guys, let me just paste that. I have already designed with that. So guys, I'll paste now. As you can see, I have just done a simple code for to understand. So now let us just understand this. So as simple, I have created one section called section, and then footer where bg dark and text white, and whatever the text inside this will be called. So guys, over here we are going to see the output of it. So now let us get back and just refresh this page. So let's refresh. Okay, so it's not coming. Why? We have not included this footer design in your main page. So let's go to apps, and you can see as you have included the navbar globally, so same way you have to include the footer also globally. Done. So let us just copy this and type as footer. So let me just type the footer thing, footer, and this footer we have to call at the top as you have called the navbar. So let me just import that, import footer from the path of your footer. So as you can see, your app.js file is over here, and directly you can go to your current directory. From the current directory, you are moving to one step in the current directory and go to inc folder, where you are going to call the we have to call the components folder first, because you are in the inside the components folder, where inside inc folder, inside inc you are going to footer.js. So .js file is already, it is defaultly calling. So let's save this and check the output once again. Okay, so let's reload this page. You can see the error. So let me just check out with what is the thing. Okay, there is no error over here. So let me just check on footer. Footer.js, what is, okay. Oh, it's not exported. So let's export that below. Export default where footer. Okay, just close this, and now let's get back. And one more thing we have to check with that link. Okay, so this link, we have to import that link also. So let's import that, import open curly and close curly, and let's import the link from the code called React Router DOM. Okay, so done. So all the link will be called. So this link, if you check in your HTML, it will be checked as a tag. Okay, so let's save it and reload once again. You can see the output, I hope. Yes guys, so we got the finally output, and this is our code design. Done. So guys, now what we have to do, okay, let me just make it this as white, text white. So just add a class into it. Class name is equal to text white. Done. And now the same thing we are going to call with that. Okay, so guys, what you have to do is that we have to design this a tags and all. So as simple, let me just inspect and show you what is the tag of it. So you have pasted the link, right? So you can see a tag over here. Done. So let's copy this and create one code for it. So let's go back. You can see the footer. So let me just copy this and go back to your app.css and paste the code. So let's type footer a, where I am going to set this color for hash triple f for the white, and then I don't want the text decoration. So let me off the text decoration where none, and I'll give important. Let's save this. Okay, so now I wanted one color on hover. So let's copy this and paste it once again until this on hover colon hover hover, where this color will be gray, gray, gray. That's it. Let's save and see the output of it. So you can see that the when we hover, everything is working fine. And let's check out with the about us page. So same way you are going to design with that. Okay, so guys, as simple, let's get started with that, which I have already done the code. I'll just paste and explain it to you. Very simple. So let's go on the about us page. So inside the pages where you can see about us.js file. So over here we are going to create with it. So let me just paste the code and explain it. So one thing we have to do. So let's remove this and remove this also. So inside one empty div tag, I am going to paste the code. So let us paste. And now guys, you can see that inside this first section, I have created one banner. Okay. So where you can see about and about us, where we have designed the column MD4 and 8. So these are divided and this will be a banner section. And then coming back to below, you can see with the section with the BG light. So BG light, we are not going to use. We are going to use custom light, where border bottom also you have given and given the heading as our company. And then you can move with the underline thing, right? So if you want to include that, the class name of your main heading, you can follow with that. So let's type the main heading. Okay. Let me just remove zero. So let's save this. And now let us see what boot out it is. Okay. So you can see the output of about us page. And now if you want to include that home page, our services, this, our vision mission, we will include in our about us page. So let us get back. And if you want to include that as you have included in your home page, as you can see this, we want to the page of this VMC, our view, vision, mission and core values. So let me include this. And again, let us call that page. So from where it is coming here. So let's copy this and go to about us and then include at the top. That's it. You are in the same directory, so it will work fine. And let's save this. And now you can check the output of it. So guys, you can find the difference. What are the things over here? So let's refresh. Cool. So the background color is getting matched, so you can make it to white, whatever the our company thing is. Okay. So let me just remove this and save. And now guys, you are done with the about us page. So as simple, you have created the section and the things. So guys, in next video, we'll be learning about contact us page. We will be creating our input box and all. Okay. In previous video where we have created our home page with this services section and all. And now guys, and with the about us page. And now what we are going to do, the contact us page design. As simple, we are going to include this banner design and as a, for the about contact us page, and over here one simple contact form with the one button, and over here your few contact details, and then as it continued, this footer will be there. Done. So guys, without wasting time, let's get started. So let us get back. And now guys, we have to check with the contact us page. So let me close all these things we do not require. So let's go to our contact page. So over here, you can see that this is the details which it is shown over here, right? So guys, now let me remove this and add one new tag. So let me just cut control X and then let me create a new div tag. So guys, now inside this div tag, we will be doing the pasting thing. So let's paste back whatever we have just now. We cut code. And now let me just get back to our about us page for the banner thing. So let me just copy this banner design and let's paste it over here. So let's paste. Okay. So now let's check the design for it output. So you can see on the contact us link, there is a content. So let us change that content. So for the about, let's make it to contact. So just press Control D on the tag and then it will be changed. So guys, now let's design one simple card for it. So the card is already designed over here. So we required only the few things. So let's make a section about it. So we have already done with that. So let me just cut this and create one section and close the tag. Okay. And now inside this, I'm going to create a class name is equal to where section, and inside this section only we are going to paste our container codes. So let's create the card. So let's remove this margin top, and where card body, where I'm going to give one small shadow, and inside this you are going to create the page of it. So before creating the container card, you have to create a row and columns. So let us just create one row. Let's open div, and now let's create a class. Class name is equal to row, and now over here the column. Oops. So let me just tab div tag, and now let's create the class name. NAME name is equal to where column MD6, and let's copy this and paste back again. So there are two columns now. So now inside these two columns, we are going to design with the contact form, as simple. So let me just tag with the H6 and tell contact form. Create one horizontal row. Let me just create HR, then give forward slash and close the tag. Okay. So directly if you close, it will show an error. Now you have to design a form. So let's get back. Okay. So if you remember Bootstrap, you can follow with me, or else you have to understand how it is going. So let's create a class name where I am going to create one form hyphen group. And inside this, we are going to create an input tag of it. So let's create first label. L-A-B-E-L label, and inside this label we will create full name, and then create an input tag with the name. Type will be text. Name you can just leave that, and over there in place of value I can just create a placeholder. So let's give placeholder, enter full name. Okay, so let's enter enter full name. Let's save this and make sure you are giving forward slash arrow and closing the tag, because it's asked the React. So guys, now let us refresh and check with the output. So let's see, reload the page. You can see this input tag is created, but let's design according the Bootstrap. So you have to add a class. So let me just change this name attribute to class name, where I'm going to add form hyphen control. Okay, let me save. And yes, so let's reload this page. You can see that the form is ready. So guys, same way you are going to add for all the things. So let me just change this class name, and where margin bottom is equal to 1. Let's copy and paste the same thing for 4 times. And now over here you can tell this as phone number, and then email address, and then final one message, and this message will be as text area. So let's create one text area for it. Text area, and inside this we are going to call the number of rows is, let's create 3, and the for this column we'll remove that and place with the class. So let's remove that and place, and let's cut this placeholder also. So let's cut and paste over here, and you can tell type your message. That's it. So let's remove this, and now guys, let's save, and you can check the output. Control R, where you can see the output of it. Cool. So as simple. Now guys, you have to save one button. You need a button. So let me just copy the same thing and remove this both line, one label, and let's replace with the text area from button. Okay, button then, and let's remove this row, and now let's change this form class name, where is button hyphen warning. Okay, so we'll just get with the warning or the primary color with the shadow, as simple. And let's remove the placeholder for it, and you can assign one type is equal to where button button, and this name will the button of send message. So let's save and reload the page. So you can see that the output of send message has come. So but little space we required, and give the width as 100. So let's give width 100, and I need margin py padding top and bottom, where I will give 3. So let's save this, and guys, you can just refresh and you can see the output. Cool. So guys, as simple, you can add one data for this also. So let me just paste that. So I have already designed with that. So let me paste. So guys, before pasting, I'll create one border hyphen le righ, right? So you can see one border over here. So it's control R. Okay, so I think it's moved to this. Let's try with border left. Okay, so it's not coming. So let's leave this and let's continue with the coding part of your form. So guys, let me paste, and here is one simple design which I have done with it. Okay, as simple, which we are using from previous video about the main heading and underline thing. So guys, that only it's included. So let's show over here, done. So it's the data has come. So guys, but I wanted the border to be displayed between these two thing. Okay, so let me just give one simple like border hyphen start. Okay, so it in Bootstrap 4.5 and all, Bootstrap 4, you can use right and left, but in case of Bootstrap 5, they have made for right and left thing, they have made replaced with start and end. Okay, so Bootstrap, for border start and border end, you can see a light border over here. Done. So guys, this is how we are setting up with the contact form. So guys, we have completed the website designing using React.js. Okay, so guys, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe, like and share.